Good job.
Ông kiểm tra báo cáo một to, cái chấm đá can để tệ vị thi xã Mna Ka. Tạm cao được phía, cổng tục, cứ trời bằng to đời khẳng cổng xã Phri Nha. Nông ca bằng hai ai cả xa để khuôn viên bằng đại cho phụ mục ông kiểm tra. Một nâng bắt đầu bị tích ca từ khẳng đồng nàng xã Phri Nha, ông kiểm tra xông xua từ đồng nàng xã Phri Nha tha ta khang tháp kinh nhà trời cà phê về liền phần màn tiết nên khăn ông cả đại cả gia chụp một mốc ông chụp ra xem ra robot robot bạ công minh campuchia đi
Good afternoon, Your Honours. Good afternoon, Council and general public. 1 hour, Your Honours, by the end of the next session. And I think the plan was that the civil party co-lawyers would commence at 3 o'clock when we come back from the break, if that's suitable to you.
Good afternoon, Your Honours. Good afternoon, Council. And general
public. 1 hour.
Thank you, Your Honours. This afternoon, I will present three more documents. All three are interviews of Mr. Yang Sari. One is in 1978, and the other two were given in 1972 during the Lon Nol War. And after that, my learned colleague will present some documents in relation to Nguyen Chia specifically to finish the presentation. Your Honours, if we can look at document D108/28.306. Now, this is a document of notes from a visit to Democratic Cambodia in September 1978 by a delegation of the Norwegian Marxist Party. And the introduction note reads as follows. A translation of notes made by Hal Stegen, who visited Democratic Cambodia for about a week around September 20, 1978. Mr. Stegen represented the Norwegian Marxist Party, and Yang Sari represented the CBDK. Your Honour, this document demonstrates Yang Sari's active involvement in the foundation and development of the party structure and policy, and also his ability to speak on behalf of the CPK. On behalf of on the issues occurring in Cambodia at that time. The first point he touches upon, there's a number of points in it, but particularly he relates the history of the party between 1954 and 1960 in some specific detail. That English ERN S000 11553, Khmer 00333344, and French 00757898. And he states, we had experience in patriotic struggle and class struggle in the period 1954 to 1960. Even if there were no party, there was an ideology. Comrades came from Thailand and France. We did not accept any foreign advice or advisors. As to Thu Samut, the Vietnamese wanted to propagate through him, but he also had a national and democratic position. Meetings of the two sides were possible after, and the date's hard to read. And since there were relations between the two sides, the Vietnamese could not insert themselves. This is the historical period when we organized our party without their influence. This is the period where we readied the statutes of the party and the enemy suppression was very hard. This is the period where we distinguish between real revolutionaries and revolutionaries who wanted to be dependent on outsiders. This is the period when the political line and the party statutes, the party's strategic and tactical line, was established without foreign advice or advisors. It came from our classes and our use of Marxism, Leninism, based on the situation here. The next point of interest is Yang Sari's statement on the building of revolutionary bases in the countryside. And this is from, he's referring to 1963 to 1967, in March of 1963, most of the SK cadres were on the countryside, and among them, Pol Pot. It wasn't the usual countryside, it was the forest. We went to Ratanakiri province in the northeast from 1963 to 1967. We lived in the forest and had contact with several villages. At the time, the party played a leading role, but indirectly. We established the line through couriers. We ourselves didn't go down to the villages. Three things were important for the party. Increase the people's movements for democracy and living conditions. The people themselves rose to the struggle for better living conditions. But in this struggle, we led our demonstrations and strikes. We used revolutionary violence. When the police and the troops came to oppress the demonstrations, the people used knives and sticks to fight the police of the enemy. Through this struggle, we built up an attitude for revolutionary violence and armed struggle. We believed in this movement, and we could start such a movement throughout the whole country, as well as in the villages. B, we attempt to build revolutionary bases. We built, especially in the northeast province of Ratanakiri, that were far from the enemy, but also in Kampon Cham, the western mountains, and Battambang. The definition of a base, as it was then: one, the people understand the revolution and hate the enemy. In other words, a good mass base. Two, people in the region could feed themselves and were independent as to distribution. Rice, corn, cotton, for example. In Ratanakiri, it was only salt that we were forced to buy. There had to be secret militia, military organising, and people working in the official sectors of the ruling class deal legally with the enemy. But certainly, and it appears that it sympathised with us. The third point I'd like to direct your honours in relation to this document is Yang Sari's statement on his knowledge of the guerrilla tactics of the Revolutionary Army from 1968 onwards. This is ERN S0011551, Khmer 0033-3340, and French 0075-7896. And he states, the enemy had the following forces. They sent 10,000 soldiers to the northeast. There were 30,000 soldiers in the whole army. We had 100 men for troops. But because of the leadership of the party, we could defend ourselves. The struggle grew. In March 1968, the armed struggle began in 17 of the 19 provinces in Kampuchea. How did we defend ourselves in the north? With guerrilla war. We cut the roads with felled trees. We laid out traps along the roads and on the ground. We weren't afraid of bombing planes. The most important were the foot soldiers. We let them come in deep and surrounded them, cut the road on which they came. In the space of 3 months, the struggle began in 17 provinces. There were 34 communes in Ratanakere. 32 were liberated in March. We killed or disabled 2,000, of whom 200 were killed, the largest amount through traps. And we used poison that went into the blood. With the help of this struggle, we were putting things right. We were, in other words, ready when the coup d'etat took place. That is the cause and effect during the period 1970-75 that the leadership of the CP, presumably CPK, carried out the liberation war. With the help of the party, the army and the United Front, we won state power, and we were on the way to an independent economy. A year after the coup d'etat, January 1971, we had the Third Party Congress. During the Congress, we reached full unity on the political line for the struggle. That article, Your Honours, is quite a detailed article, and it gives another level of understanding of the policies and the structure from Yang Sary. I now turn to the second document, and this is D312.2.8. And this is an interview with Yang Sary, which was published in the Le Monde newspaper on the 15th of January 1972. And it's entitled Interview with a Cambodian Revolutionary, with the following preamble. In Peking, our special correspondent, Claude Julien, recently met with Mr. Yang Sary, one of the historical leaders of the Cambodian Revolution. He, who soon will return to the underground, reveals here for the first time to a foreign journalist his view on the evolution of the country. This is January 72. This document, Your Honours, is highly relevant in relation to providing a contemporaneous account by the accused of the political, military and historical situation status of the resistance movement in Cambodia as of that time. I can take Your Honours to a few particular points, and firstly in relation to his statements on the role of the National United Front of Kampuchea, Funk, and that's English ERN 0003965, Khmer 0074-4041, and French 0072-2246. He states, finally, the specific trait dominant in our war is the current epoch. In the current epoch is a solid union in the bosom of Funk of all of the nation's patriotic forces. Never has a united national front assembled such broad forces. From a former king, the country's legal chief of state, animated by a great patriotism and by a resolute determination to win to the most disinherited peasant, not to mention the members of the royal family. The national bourgeoisie, the petty bourgeoisie, the workers, the intellectuals, the monks, etc. This front and its government represents the legality, the legitimacy, and the continuity of the state. The unity between the interior party and the exterior party of Funk is solid. He comments in this article on the role of the royal government of the National Union Grunt at ERN 0003965. Khmer 0074-4042-43 and French 0072-2246. 46, where he states, the Royal Government of National Union is the only legal and legitimate government of Cambodia, with Samdek Pen Nut as Premier and Khieu Samphan as Vice Premier. It is the outgrowth of the broad and solid union of all social classes and strata. It is recognised by 28 countries which have broken with Phnom Penh and given valuable aid and firm support to our people. The next point he raises is the necessity for rural bases to support the communist movement. And that's at English ERN 000-3964, Khmer 0074-4039, and French 0072-242246. And he states, these principal bases of support can only be built in the countryside, is the bosom of the people and under their protection. The factor determining victory is man, the people, politically aware of the struggle that they must lend. These years of struggle have also taught us the necessity of knowing how to apply in a creative way on all fronts of the armed, the political, and the diplomatic struggle, the principles of always preserving our independence, of counting primarily on our own strength, and of being our own masters. He further provides more understanding of the administrative, political, and military structures in the area under the control of the revolutionary forces. And I refer to English 0000-3963, Khmer 0074-4036, and French 0072-2245. Where he states, in the vast liberated zone, we have applied the FUNK program. It rests on the principle by which, quote, the people are the source of all power. At all administrative levels, from the hamlets, the villages, the districts, the provinces, committees are functioning as the state apparatus. Each committee is composed of 3, 5, or 7 members, according to the importance of its echelon. Each member is assigned one or more specific duties: political, military, security, economic, cultural, and social affairs, etc. The committee members are democratically elected by representatives of all classes of the population and must have the following qualifications: be devoted to the cause of FUNK and struggle firmly against the American imperialist aggression and their servants, be honest and have exemplary moral character, be entirely devoted to the people and the common interest, and be loved by the people. Each task is simplified to the maximum at each echelon. The number of functionaries is kept low to assure a disciplined political force among the people and to obtain their full help in the resistance. Our cadres go into the villages to live with the people and direct the task of political, cultural, and military education. They take part in production without receiving any pay, and they live frugally. The next point is in relation to his knowledge of the organization of the revolutionary forces, and that's at 0000-3964, English, Khmer 0074-4039, and French 0072-2246. He states, thus our popular armed forces have rapidly organized and developed themselves on all these levels and are composed of 3 principal forces, guerrilla units, the regional forces, and the regular forces, all placed under the command of a national military committee and its staff. At the level of each military region, there is a military committee and a regional staff. And the last point I'd like to bring your honour's attention in this document is in relation to party policy regarding enemies to the revolution, and that's of January 72. The question is, this is from the interviewer, do you think there are in the administration in Army of Phnom Penh forces or people with whom you would be able to cooperate in the future? Who do you exclude specifically from your national union? Answer, FUNK brings together all the social classes and strata, all the professional or religious organisations, all the key patriotic people and the members of the royal family, both in the country and abroad. None are excluded from the ranks except the traitors Lon Nol, Sirat Mutak, Son Nyok Tan, and their clique in the service of imperialism, those who have compromised themselves in the coup d'etat and who do not want to make amends for their crime. The broad union realized in the bosom of FUNK demonstrates that there is not, and cannot be any third force whatsoever between us. On the one hand, and the traitors and their master, aggressive American imperialism on the other. Now, Your Honours, if I move to the last document, and this document is a record of an interview with Mr. Yang Sari again on the 31st of January 1972, and it's document number D3667.1.632, and it was published in the Vietnam Courier on that date, and it's entitled Cambodia 1972, interview with Mr. Yang Sari, FUNK and Grunk, Inland Branch, Special Envoy. And if I take you straight to some particular points, he elaborates on the FUNK program again at S000307, Khmer S0072-1515, and French 0042-0910. And he states, and this translation is quite small, but it is to secure that peace that all our people are more than ever resolved to fight valiantly on the military, political, and diplomatic fronts to realize the FUNK political program of ousting the US imperialist aggressors and their Saigon and Bangkok henchmen, and sweeping away the Phnom Penh traitors in order to recover sovereignty and territorial integrity and hold an independent, peaceful, neutral, democratic, and prosperous Cambodia. To this end, our people are determined to surmount all difficulties and make every sacrifice, even though US imperialism opposes on us a protracted war. They are fighting and will fight unflinchingly, uncompromisingly against the Phnom Penh clique of traitors, for the only way to national salvation and to a lasting peace is the FUNK. All hope or attempt of the Americans and their quislings to dictate to our people any compromise, solution under whatever form it may be, chiefly a solution of petition, will only be a bitter delusion and a premium to the Yankees and their agents to drag on their criminal war. Your Honours, this document, in fact, doesn't have a translation, but this interview was reproduced in the FUNK paper called Cambodia 1972 by Yang Sari, and it's that reproduction that in fact has been translated. If I now turn to The second point from this article, and it's, he provides more information as to his knowledge of combat operations in Cambodia at the time, and he states, but all these criminal schemes have met with dramatic failure. In the flush of their past victories, our people and armed forces in the last rainy season inflicted stinging reverses on the enemy in Operation Chen La Tu. The Rum Long battle has gone down in our history as one of our biggest military feats. Then our People's Liberation Armed Forces unremittingly hammered at the enemy positions everywhere, chiefly in the periphery of Phnom Penh. He explains further to the interviewer the tactical methods used by the revolutionary forces, and that's at ERN S0003046. Khmer S00072158 and French 00420902-3. And he states, our Cambodian National Liberation People's Armed Forces have been built and developed very rapidly in every respect, in number, in strength, quality, spirit, combat efficiency and technique. The three categories of arms guerrillas, regional troops and regular army are placed under the supreme command of a national military committee assisted by a staff. The regional troops are now organized in battalion size and the regular army in regimental size. They are equipped with arms of all kinds and have mainly a very high political awareness and a firm resolve to drive all the US imperialist aggressors and their henchmen out of Cambodia and wipe out all the Phnom Penh clique of Quislings headed by Lon Nol, Sirak Matak, and Son Nyok Tan. All the army men live in the midst of the people, in close touch with them, like them, and serve them heart and soul. Their tactical methods are based on incessant guerrilla operations mounted by skillful, light, mobile, and discreet guerrilla units to scatter the enemy forces and harass them, leaving them no time to replenish their force and to make use of their physical and moral resiliency. Lightning and devastating raids have been sprung by the CNLPAF forces, special commandos eager to win on enemy manpower and war materials. The Poh Chin Tong air base destruction is a vivid example of this spirit. In all of these coups, the decisive factor of success, as our experience has shown, is man. The decisive weapon in his high political consciousness, which makes it possible for him to get a clear picture of the real nature of the enemy and his fortes and foibles. The last three points, Your Honour, and the next one is in relation to the CPK and FUNK cooperative policy in existence at the time of 1972, and the English ERN S0002346, Khmer 00721509, and French 00420904, where he states, to bring to fruition that agrarian policy in conformity with the FUNK political program, we are carrying out intensive agitation work among the peasants, rich and poor, in order to drive home to them that policy for its strict implementation. Those who eagerly apply it are staunch fighters in our war for national salvation. The organization of all the peasants who approved the agrarian reform into a patriotic Peasants Association. We have encouraged the establishment of producers' cooperatives and consumers' cooperatives to eliminate middlemen. In agricultural production, the mutual aid movement has been largely expanded among the peasants. In each fund committee at all administrative levels, a responsible cadre is appointed to see to the development of production whose main objective is to cater for our resistance war. Parallel to political education and the mutual aid movement, the peasants have been endeavouring to improve two rice crops per year. In anticipation of a prolonged war, we attach great importance to subsidiary crops and the rearing of pigs and poultry. He also comments on the education policy in the liberated areas, and that's at English ERN S0023046, Khmer S0072151, and French 0042-0905, and to 06. Thank you, Your Honour. I apologise for that. English ERN S0023046, Khmer S0072-1511, and French 0042-0905-06. And he states in relation to its education policy, throughout the liberated zone, education is entirely free of charge. Everywhere, literacy classes have been functioning. Of course, the enemy raids impede the education of children a great deal. The US imperialist aggressors, their Saigon Quislings and the Lon Nol Sirik Matak Sonyok Tan clique of traitors are most barbarous. They erase everything with bombs, schools, colleges, hospitals and pagodas. And despite all this, we have been able to readjust education to the war conditions. An education based on political economy, medical and military sciences. We also see to the cultural and artistic instruction. It is given entirely in Khmer. Freed from all harmful outside influences, it closes links. It closely links theory to practice in the particular conditions of the country. It is squared with the specific national requirements at the present time. And the last point, he relates policies in relation to healthcare and medicine, and that's it in the liberated areas, and that's at English S0023047, Khmer S0072-1511, and French 0042-0906-07. And the question is put to him, can your medical organization meet the needs of the war and population? And he states, generally speaking, our medical organization satisfies the requirements of the war and the population. The medicines used are made from simple ingredients and have proved efficacious in traditional therapeutics. We train male nurses and midwives. Most of them are poor country people and even illiterate. The training lasts 3 years, 3 months of theory and 9 months of practice a year. The medical staff counts many women. In addition to the medical setup of the CNL PAF, there are two male nurses in each hamlet, a medical committee in each village, a physician in each district, and one of several hospitals in each province. Your Honours, that finishes the documents that were particularly relevant in relation to Mr. Yang Sari, the main reason being, of course, is that he was the author of most of these documents. And we certainly won't be making submissions, but all we would like to say, all I'd like to say, is that these documents are relevant to showing his activity in the CPK regime from its inception right up till 1975. It's evidence of his close collaboration with the main members of the leadership of the CPK from the 50s right through to 1975, and his fervent activity throughout all of that period to be a part of the CPK revolution. Thank you, and I'll hand it over to my national colleague who will present some documents in relation to Nguyen Chia. Thank you.
សូមគោរពលោកប្រធានសូមគោរពលោកលោកស្រីចៅក្រមសូមគោរពអង្គសាវនាការសួស្តីលោកអ្នកទាំងឡាយដែលចូលរួមក្នុងសាវនាការនេះនៅក្នុងបន្ទប់នៅក្រៅបន្ទប់មុននឹងនេះខ្ញុំបាទសូមការអនុញ្ញាតពីលោកចៅក្រមពីសាលារបងសូមទាញចំណាប់អារម្មណ៍តឡាការចម្ពោះសេចក្តីថ្លែង ការតាក់ទងនឹងឯកសារព្រឹកមិញដែលសហប្រញ្ញាបានលើកជាពិសេសតាក់ទងរឿងបទសម្ភាសជារបស់លោកស្ទីវិនហេដឺជាមួយនឹងលោកអៀងសេរីនៅក្នុងឯកសារ 20.2 យើងក៏សម្គាល់ហើយដើម្បីជាកំណត់ត្រានៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងផងយើងក៏សម្គាល់ឃើញថាការបកប្រែឯកសារមានខុសគឺមិនត្រូវតាមសម្ដីរបស់លោកអៀងសេរីនិយាយទាំងស្រុងទេ ให้กับห้องนี้งุนทงโอเจ็บเสกยมสมเลือกยกยกไอกระซาเลกไอเอสไพจดกับมวยอีออนจีประสังเลกือโซนโซนสายมวยจัดประมวย សូនប្រាំបីដល់សូនប្រាំបួននិងជាភាសាខ្មែរសូនសូនសូនប្រាំមួយម្ភៃបួនហកសិបប្រាំខ្ញុំសូមដកស្រង់ខ្លះហើយស្ទាញចំណាប់អារម្មណ៍ថាការបកប្រែនោះ ខុសហើយគ្រោះថ្នាក់បំផុតខ្ញុំសូមលើកសម្ដីនេះខ្លះមកជូនតុលាការពិចារណាហើយនឹងការបកប្រែលោកស្ទីវគាត់ផ្ដើមហើយយុបល់ច្រើននៅចំណុចនេះគាត់និយាយខ្ញុំលើកឧទាហរណ៍ថាគាត់ថាឥឡូវខ្ញុំសូមត្រឡប់ ទៅបញ្ហាក្រសួងការបរទេសវិញហើយតាមការពិតដើម្បីយោងអំពីបញ្ហាក្រសួងការបរទេសនឹងយើងត្រូវត្រឡប់ទៅពេលដែលលោកមានបេសកកម្មទៅបេកាំងវិញបើតាមខ្ញុំយល់កាល7មួយដែលលោកទៅបេកាំងអានេះខ្ញុំសន្និដ្ឋាន ការងារដែលចាត់តាំងឲ្យធ្វើបើតាមការប៉ាន់ស្មានទី1ដោយក្រោយ75ដែរខ្ញុំមិនលើកទាំងអស់ទាំងស្រុងទេខ្ញុំលើកចំណុចឃ្លាចុងក្រោយហើយខ្ញុំក៏ឃើញថាក្រោយមកលោកយកជាពិសេសអ្នកដែលចូលជាមួយបកនៅពេលកາງនឹងមក ដើម្បីធ្វើជាកម្មាភិបាលហើយអ្នកការងារនៅក្រសួងការបរទេសត្រង់ចំណុចចំឡោយខ្ញុំក៏ឃើញសម្គាល់ថា ọt trâu hay ọt chọn thoáng nâng ong lê cọt khmai cọt chlói thà chà mưa lũ yên dữ cọt chlói thà ca bất mên tên tư đô chìa lục chuôn bà sật ong lê cọt thà nhóm chạc lạc lạc đáy that is really true phía xa khmai ọt chọn ọt trâu tê bàn đây thà bởi dây thà that is really true bàn đây thà quát tỏ tuôn xua là vây là dây hạng đá mô trâm trâu mên tên tăng ọt thầm đó tai ta bất phía xa khmai nữ tên ni mần chân tê lúc yên dí cháu ta ca bất mên tên tử việc viên vì nâng vì ọt châu là nâng tê có chọn dây thà xê mì nâng lớp vì nâng khổm nâng mân tật tua cho cả vấy đầy dây môn mò tê phía xa khmai dây chân chân nít quán ta chìa thì hò muối đâm bay cai đầm râu khi nhóm hạ mê tư vi ca phía lục cái đây lục yên sử nào xông ta la ca bằng quốc oi bọ prai ai cái xa ní chẳng sông lãng vinh đâm bay oi bán trâm trâu làm mấy ai là tua cho bạn tặng ốc này xong ốc con
khang đầm nàng thạp rì nhá, giang mạch đáy ai kia xa đài bàn lực lần tò và đời bì tư vi chiết kà phía đây lục yên xử rì lư ai kia xa bánh mây ní làm vì bánh hạ khlâm xa này kà bọ prai phía xa thì tại vì miền bánh hạ giang mạch đáy hay ai châm nông chìa miền kà phòn trả lâm bẩn tích lư bánh hạ ai cả xa đám tâm nông chi phía xa khmai vì phố phở bị bích đài chi ở xo xâm nê ni miền này tha chi ca đọ xa răng nơi chi ca con tra làng vinh nơi xâm đây này dì mà này chi phía xa nâng dọc một chi phía xa dì một riêng chi phía xa xa xê chẳng hãy ban chi miền lạc nạ lũng bác và thiệp cho mùi nâng phía xa xa xê thoa mà đá cứ miền lạc nạ khó phí nì chẳng ai miền chấm nói khác khi tha para bị đọt đài lên cái lực gran xa đại sa chỉ bị gì u thì họ được nam cao sự buồn những cao sự buồn cao sự buồn những cái trang lực gran xa bị sơ sê bị chỉ phải sa không ai mình ai sơ sê được như thế bàn gì những cứ tụm đầu khi ai cái sa ní ai chỉ khi sa đó chỉ phải sa không ai vấn đề lấy đâm mấy chú ba hàng lô kia đài chỉ mà cha đầm để cả đại cái sa nó tại lục miền mà tệ gì bò thì mấy lưu pành hà cà cọt tụm cọt rồi cả tàu vá rồi bò nâng ca sản xuất một bộ trong bây giờ vì chiết cà phê đây lục yên dưới đi lưu bánh hai cái xa đại bàn bằng hai nhìn nâng to ba bánh mình đi.
Thank you, Your Honor. I'd love to have the language skills to provide a precise answer on that. And obviously, my learned friend's language skills are far greater than on this side of the bench. But I would say that it is an important interview. And that is an important answer, of course. So I would say it's worthwhile to resubmit at least that answer to the translation section and have them review that against the tape and then just file a revised version of that answer. And I would say, in relation to other parts of the document, that because it is on tape, our learned friends can listen to his reporting. They can listen to that tape. And if they find that there's an issue or a problem with a particular part, I think they should raise that. And, of course, we'd have that review. But I would say, at this stage, in terms of resources, I think a review of that answer, that page, would be appropriate because it's important for it to be clear.
អរគុណសូមជម្រាបលោកមេធាវីជាតិការពារក្តីលោកយើងសេរីសូមអរគុណលោកប្រធានតាមពិតករណីមិនមែនជាការច្រឡំហើយមិនមែនជាកំហុសតូចតាចទេគ្រាន់តែបដូរនៃបន្តិចវានៃវាទៅទាំងស្រុងទៅហើយអមមកយើងបដូរនៃពីវិជ្ជមានទៅអវិជ្ជមានវិញទាំងស្រុងបាត់ទៅហើយហើយវាមានបញ្ហាធ្ងន់ធ្ងរអង់គ្លេសបច្ចៈធ្ងន់ធ្ងរបាត់ហើយគេថា that is really true តែខ្មែរអត់និយាយយ៉ាងផងហ្នឹងខ្មែរនិយាយថាការពិតមែនតែនទៅនោះវាចេញទៅណានោះនៃខ្មែរនោះមិនទទួលយកអាហ្នឹងទេគេចង់និយាយរឿងផ្សេងទៅវិញទេអញ្ចឹងដើម្បីឲ្យច្បាស់យើងខ្ញុំនៅតែរក្សាសំណុំពរដដែលសូមឲ្យមានការបកប្រែឯកសារនេះត្រឹមត្រូវឡើងវិញហើយចំពោះពាក្យបច្ចេកទេសឬមួយខ្លឹមសារនេះហើយខ្លឹមសារនៃពាក្យបច្ចេកទេសទាំងអស់ហើយនឹងខ្លឹមសារទាំងមូលតែម្ដងយើងស្នើសុំថាឲ្យមានការបកប្រែលើឯកសារនេះទាំងស្រុងដើម្បីឲ្យបានទទួលទាំងអស់គ្នាឲ្យបានត្រឹមត្រូវទាំងអស់គ្នាសូមអរគុណ
បាទហើយឥឡូវនេះក្រោយបានវិភាសាគ្នានៅក្នុងចំណោមជាក្រុមនៃអង្គជំរះអង្គជំរះយល់ឃើញថាបញ្ហានេះពិតជាមានកើតមានមែននៅក្នុងឡុងពេលនៃដំណើរការសំណុំរឿងក្តីនេះក្នុងការបកប្រែភាសាផ្សេងៗប៉ុន្តែក៏មិនមែនជារឿងធំធេងណាស់ណានោះទេដែលយើងអាចធ្វើកិច្ចការនេះបានហើយដើម្បីឲ្យកាន់តែច្បាស់លាស់ហើយដើម្បីដោះស្រាយបញ្ហានេះបានជាស្រឡះសូមឲ្យមេធាវីជាតិការពារក្តីលោកអៀងសេរី ដាក់ឯកសារស្នើសុំជាលិលាអសហើយសូមបញ្ជាក់ឲ្យបានច្បាស់លាស់នៅបញ្ហាទាំងប៉ុន្មានដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធទៅនឹងបញ្ហាដែលមានចំពោះឯកសារនេះហើយនឹងសំណើសុំឲ្យបានធ្វើយ៉ាងដូចម្តេចឲ្យបានច្បាស់លាស់ដើម្បីអង្គជំរះយកមកពិនិត្យពិចារណាហើយរៀបចំឲ្យបានត្រឹមត្រូវតែម្ដងពីព្រោះវាសិតតែជារឿងសំខាន់ទាំងអស់គ្នា
អត់ចំបុគ្គលវិទ្យាជូនទៅក្រមវិទ្យាការពីក្រមតំណាងសហប្រញ្ញាបន្តកិច្ចការរបស់ខ្លួនសូមអញ្ជើញបាទសូមអរគុណលោកប្រធានខ្ញុំនឹងបង្ហាញឯកសារដែលមានសារៈសំខាន់មួយចំនួនចំពោះមុខអង្គជំនុំរះហើយឯកសារនេះក៏អាចជួយដល់អង្គជំនុំរះក្នុងការកំណត់អំពីភាពត្រឹមត្រូវ នៅពលរដ្ឋមានតាក់ទងទៅនឹងសាវតាដែលបានរៀបរាប់ដោយជនជាប់ចោតនួនជានៅក្នុងសេចក្តីថ្លែងការណ៍មុនរបស់គាត់ឬក៏ចម្លើយរបស់គាត់ដែលបានឆ្លើយជូនតុលាការនេះកាលពីកន្លងមកហើយដែរហើយយើងឃើញថានៅពេលខ្លះជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាគឺបានផ្ដល់ព័ត៌មានឬក៏ចម្លើយដែលមានសារៈសំខាន់និងមានប្រយោជន៍សម្រាប់អង្គជំនុំរះ ហើយនៅក្នុងករណីជាច្រើនទៀតក៏យើងឃើញដែរថាឯកសារនេះបានបង្ហាញថាលោកនួនជានឹងគឺមិនបានផ្ដល់ព័ត៌មានត្រឹមត្រូវឬក៏មានការលាក់បាំងព័ត៌មានខ្លះទៅតាមការវិវត្តដែលតាក់ទងទៅនឹងគោលមេគានិងគោលនយោបាយរបស់បកគុម្មុយនីស្តកម្ពុជានៅខែ ហើយបន្តទៅទៀតនេះខ្ញុំសូមអនុញ្ញាតពីលោកប្រធានដើម្បីដាក់បញ្ចាំងឯកសារនៅក្នុងអេក្រង់ដើម្បីជូនអង្គសាមណការមកពិនិត្យមើលបាទសូមជញ្ជិញមេធាវីការពារក្តីលោកនួនជា
Thank you, Your Honor. Very briefly, if perhaps we could refrain today from characterizing the nature of the evidence given today. I don't think that's what we're here for today. I did hear counsel refer to Nunchia's testimony as being inaccurate or not correct or something like that. I think perhaps that's going beyond the scope of today's exercise.
បាទក៏ជំទាស់របស់លោកមេធាវីអន្តរជាតិការពារក្តីលោកនួនជាគឺមានមូលដ្ឋានត្រឹមត្រូវដូច្នេះសូមតំណាងសហប្រញ្ញាជាតិប្រឹងប្រែងអនុវត្តនៅក្នុងការបង្ហាញឯកសារនេះឲ្យបានត្រឹមត្រូវតាមការណែនាំរបស់អង្គជំរះជៀសវាងការវិភាគវាតម្លៃទៅលើឯកសារនានា អាចឈានដល់ការសន្និដ្ឋានព្រោះនាវេទិកានេះគឺវេទិកាដាក់ឯកសារសូមអញ្ជើញ
បាទសូមអរគុណលោកប្រធាននៅខ្ញុំនឹងបន្តទៅទៀតសូមអនុញ្ញាតពីអង្គជំនុំរះដើម្បីដាក់ឯកសារបង្ហាញ នៅលើអេក្រង់ដើម្បីជូនអង្គសំណាការបានមើលតែម្ដងបាទហើយឯកសារដំបូងនេះគឺខ្ញុំសូមបង្ហាញថាមានលេខ D20 ឬក៏ E3/54 ដែលជាកំណត់ហេតុចូលខ្លួនដំបូងរបស់នួនជានៅតុលាការនេះពោលគឺនៅចំពោះមុខសហចក្រមសើបង្កេតកាលពីថ្ងៃទី 19 ខែកញ្ញាឆ្នាំ 2007 ការចូលខ្លួនដំបូងរបស់លោកនួនជានៅចំពោះមុខតុលាការនេះបានផ្ដល់ ចំឡើយដល់សាស្ត្រាចារ្យក្រុមសិស្សបង្កេតគឺនៅត្រង់ឯកសារ EAN ជាភាសាខ្មែរដែលមានលេខ 00 1 4 8 7 4 3និងជាភាសាអង់គ្លេស 00 1 4 8 8 1 7ជាភាសាបារាំង គឺ 00 1 4 8 9 2 0ដែលមានខ្លឹមសារដូចតទៅនៅឆ្នាំ 1950ខ្ញុំចេញទៅតស៊ូរំដោះជាតិពីអាណានិគមនិយមបារាំងដោយស្មោះត្រង់ខ្ញុំសុកចិត្តលះបង់ការរៀនសូត្រនិងការងាររាជការដែលខ្ញុំមាន ព្រោះប្រទេសជាតិនៅក្រោមអាណានិគមរបស់បារាំងនៅឆ្នាំ 1954មានកិច្ចព្រមព្រៀងក្រុងហ្សឺណែវតាមខ្ញុំចាំកងទ័ពបរទេសទាំងអស់ត្រូវដកចេញពីកម្ពុជាហើយអ្នកតស៊ូខ្មែរត្រូវរំសាយនិងចូលមករស់នៅក្នុងសង្គមជាតិវិញខ្ញុំសុកចិត្តចូលមករស់នៅតាមការសម្រេចនេះ រដ្ឋប្រហារទម្លាក់សម្ដេចសីហនុឆ្នាំ 1970បំផ្លាញអព្យាក្រឹតភាពរបស់កម្ពុជាខ្ញុំចេញទៅតស៊ូទៀតចម្លើយនេះគឺឃើញថាវាមានសារៈសំខាន់ពាក់ព័ន្ធទៅនឹងការលើកឡើងរបស់ជនជាប់ចោទនួនជាដែលបានបង្ហាញនៅចំពោះមុខអង្គជំនុំជម្រះដែលកាយឡ័យសហជាក្រុមសិស្សបង្កេតកាលពីឆ្នាំ 2007 ហើយដែលនៅពេលនោះគឺលោកនួនជាបានធ្វើការពន្យល់ជូនសហជាក្រុមសិស្សបង្កេតអំពីប្រវត្តិដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធទៅនឹងបកកុម្មុយនីស្តកម្ពុជានិងបដិវត្តន៍ខ្មែរក្រហមហើយគាត់បានព្យាយាមផ្ដល់មិនផ្ដល់ព័ត៌មានច្រើនតទៅនឹងប្រវត្តិតស៊ូរបស់គាត់ក្នុងឆ្នាំ 1954ដល់ឆ្នាំ 1970ទេនៅក្នុងការចូលរួមចូលខ្លួនរបស់លោកនួនជាបាន បានបញ្ជាក់ប្រាប់តុលាការថាគាត់បានដកខ្លួនចេញពីការតស៊ូហើយសុកចិត្តចូលមករស់ក្នុងសង្គមជាតិវិញចាប់ពីឆ្នាំ 1954ហើយមិនបានចូលក្នុងចលនាតស៊ូនេះទៀតទេរហូតដល់បន្ទាប់ពីខែមិនិនាឆ្នាំ 1960ដែលជាថ្ងៃរដ្ឋប្រហារទម្លាក់សម្ដេចព្រះនរោត្តមសីហនុទើបគាត់ចេញទៅតស៊ូទៀត ហើយបើយើងពិនិត្យទៅលើឯកសារដែលមានដែលជាសេចក្តីថ្លែងការណ៍របស់លោកនុនជានៅចំពោះមុខអង្គជំនុំជំរះនេះកាលពីកន្លងមកឃើញថាគាត់បានបញ្ជាក់ថាចាប់ពីឆ្នាំ 1960ដល់70គឺគាត់បានគឺជាស្ថាបនិកសំខាន់របស់បកកុម្មុយនីស្តកម្ពុជាជាមួយនឹងប៉ុលពតដែលជាមនុស្សម្នាក់ក្នុងចំណោមអ្នកដឹកនាំពីររូបនៃចលនាបដិវត្តន៍ដែលបានបង្កើតគោលមេគារបស់បក ហើយត្រូវបានយកទៅអនុវត្តនៅមហាសន្និបាតលើកទី1នៅក្នុងឆ្នាំ 1960លោកនុនជាបានផ្ដល់សក្ខីកម្មថ្លែងការណ៍របស់គាត់គឺថានៅគាត់គឺជាសកម្មជនក្នុងបដិវត្តន៍ចាប់តាំងពីឆ្នាំ 1964ដល់ឆ្នាំ 1960ហើយឯកសារដែលបានដាក់បង្ហាញដោយសារប្រញ្ញានេះគឺបានបង្ហាញថា គាត់មិនបានផ្ដល់ព័ត៌មានជាក់លាក់ទៅនឹងអ្វីដែលគាត់បានលើកឡើងនៅក្នុងអង្គសម្មនាការនេះទេហើយចំណុចមួយទៀតខ្ញុំនឹងបង្ហាញឯកសារមួយទៀតដែរដែលជាឯកសារមានសារៈប្រយោជន៍សម្រាប់អង្គជំនុំជម្រះក្នុងដំណាក់កាលនេះផងដែរឯកសារនោះគឺមានលេខ IS 20.23 ឬក៏ E 3/3គឺជាបទសម្ភាសជាមួយលោកនុនជាដែលធ្វើឡើងដោយខែមុននៅក្នុងខែឧសភាឆ្នាំ 1998ឯកសារនេះគឺជន់ចប់ចោតបានបង្ហាញអំពីប្រវត្តិសាវតានៃចលនាតស៊ូរបស់បកកុម្មុយនីស្តកម្ពុជាដែលបានកើតឡើងក្នុងព្រឹត្តិការណ៍ នេះពេលកន្លងទៅហើយឯកសារនេះក៏មានផ្ទុកព័ត៌មានជាច្រើនដែលលោកនួនជាអាចមានការផ្លេចផ្លាំងមកពេលនេះខ្ញុំសូមលើកចំណុចមួយចំនួនដែលមាននៅក្នុងឯកសារលេខ ឧទាហរណ៍បើយើងពិនិត្យទៅមើលសេចក្តីថ្លែងការណ៍របស់ជនចាប់ចោតនៅចំពោះមុខអង្គសំណាការឃើញថាលោកនួនជាគឺគាត់បានបដិសេធមិនមែនជាលេខាក្រមភ្នំពេញទេចាប់ពីឆ្នាំ1858ដល់ឆ្នាំ1860អញ្ជើញមេធាវីការពិក្តីនួនជា
Thank you, Your Honor. Just having a bit of a hard time following. I understood that we were going to be presenting specific documents and then having a look at those documents, seeing those documents on the screen, and then they would be read out. It really sounds now like we're getting into substantive pleading, and I want to make it very clear, we do not object at all to introductory remarks as to why particular documents are relevant, as to where they go, things like that, but I'm really having a hard time following what's happening at the moment. What documents are we talking about? Which portions are we talking about? It really sounds like a closing submission to me. And again, let me reiterate, no objection to introductory submissions as to why documents are relevant, placing them in the proper context, that is perfectly acceptable.
មតិជំទាស់របស់
ដែលកម្រិតត្រឹមតែកំណត់អំពីសារៈសំខាន់នៃឯកសារហើយនឹងភាពពាក់ព័ន្ធរបស់វាទៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងសូមជឿនបាទសូមអរគុណលោកប្រធានខ្ញុំនឹងធ្វើតាមហើយតាមពិតទៅការដែលលើករបស់ខ្ញុំនេះគឺគ្រាន់តែចង់ដាក់ទៀងផ្ទាត់ឯកសារមួយទៅនឹងឯកសារមួយទៅប៉ុណ្ណោះហើយជាបន្តខ្ញុំសូមបង្ហាញនៅឯកសារ
Machum Kangno, Dok Nom Tai, Kang Mondol Kiri, Rotanakiri. I can let them off Kuk Nyum. Knyum, the mock, Pontai Pelno, Chai Chippi Halley. The mock got Kang near a day. Mamong, Kang Kampong Chanang. Sopum, Kang Bopir. Pontai Crown Kanai Nom Robok Nyum. Tang T Krong. ទាំងអីទាំងអស់នៅក្នុងផ្នែកជាមួយគ្នានេះដែរគឺត្រង់លេខ ENGPSA ខ្មែរដែលមានលេខ 0 0 0 7 8 1 9 8ហើយជាភាសាអង់គ្លេសគឺ 0 0 1 8 4 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 6 សោភឹមអាកើអាវ៉នវេតប្រជុំនៅក្នុងភ្នំពេញនៅផ្ទះអាវ៉នវេតសម្រាប់ថាយើងត្រូវតែរួមសំអាវុធនិងនយោបាយចង់ 67ហើយសម្រាប់នេះមិនមែនឲ្យព្រមគ្នាទេគឺថាឲ្យគឺថាកន្លែងណាមានលទ្ធភាពបំពាក់វគ្គធ្វើកបកម្មអាវុធនិងនយោបាយរួមសំធ្វើមុនទៅ កាលនោះយើងគ្មានការតាក់ទងជាមួយផ្នែកខាងរតនគិរីទេពីព្រោះអត់មានម៉ាស៊ីនអីទាំងអស់អត់មានទេអត់មានទេអូអីទេមានតែដើរជើងដើរទៅមួយខែមកមួយខែហើយមិនងាយទៅមកឯណាអត់ទេហើយជាបន្តមកទៀតគឺ លោកនុនជាបានរៀបរាប់នៅក្នុងផ្នែកជាមួយគ្នានេះដែរអំពីការចាប់ផ្ដើមវាយប្រហារដោយអាវុធរបស់បកគុំនេះកម្ពុជាគឺបានផ្ទុះអាវុធនៅបាយតំរាមខេត្តបាត់ដំបងដែលយោងទៅតាមការសម្រេចរបស់ក្នុងកិច្ចប្រជុំរបស់គាត់ហើយខ្ញុំសូមលើកនៅឯកសារនេះផងដែរគឺ ឯកសារដែលលោកនុនជាបានឆ្លើយចំពោះជូនអង្គសម្នាការផងដែរគឺលោកនុនជាបានបញ្ជាក់ថាគាត់បានចូលរួមប្រជុំសម្រេចការតស៊ូដោយប្រើអាវុធនេះហើយឈ្មោះពេញរបស់ឈ្មោះកើដែលបានលើកអំបញ្ញមិញគឺឈ្មោះគាត់គឺឈ្មោះគង់សុផលហើយឈ្មោះនេះគឺបានចូលរួមក្នុងមហាសន្និបាតលើកទី ឆ្នាំ 1963 ផងដែរ យើងខ្ញុំសូមលើកឯកសារដែលមានលេខ ERN IS20.28 ដែលជាបទសម្ភាសរបស់លោកនុនជាជាមួយនឹងខែមុនដែលមានលេខ ERN ជាភាសាខ្មែរគឺ 00 07 8190 ERN ជាភាសាអង់គ្លេសគឺ 00184660 ហើយជាភាសាបារាំងគឺ 00596133 លោកនុនជាបានលើកឡើងថាលោកអៀងសេរីបានចូលរួមជាមួយគាត់និងប៉ុលពតនៅក្នុងគណៈកម្មាធិការបកក្រុងភ្នំពេញ ចាប់ពីឆ្នាំ 1955 ហើយឯកសារចំណុចមួយទៀតដែរគឺនៅត្រង់លេខ ERN ជាភាសាខ្មែរ son, 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 prampi, prampai, mui, prambun, pramui. Chibisa angles, son, son, mui, prambai, bun, pramui, pramui, prambai. Hay chibisa barang, son, son, pram, prambun, pramui, mui, prambun, son, nay aigasa, is, ma pai, choi, ma pai, bambai, ku. Lok nun chi ban rip rob dai tha. Kot ku chi net norm in sari cheng, pipnum ping, nong chanam, upon the motor hocks of bay. But top imin kabaka, chi sat here narrow box, and I say no. The ban come not on pi ka dok norm. Natchway ni yum. Hey. Chấm nốt mũi tiết đá cứ ai cái xa nó trăng yêu anh chị bị xa không mai lệch sốn 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 bầm pi bầm bấy mũi bầm buôn bầm buôn yêu anh chị bị xa ông class sốn sốn mũi bầm bấy buôn bầm mũi bầm pi mũi nâng chị bị xa bà rắn sốn sốn bầm bầm buôn ประมวยมวยประมวยใบดอลประมวยมวยในเอกสารดอดได้ลูกนุ่นชี้บานรีบรอบอัมพีการนอมประปนระบอบโปรโปรประปนระบอบเอียงสรีนังประปนระบอบส้นเส้นต่อการมันตีมารอยยิมส้มดอกสรองกรมซาโดยต่อเติมเมียนมูลฐานของไอ้คลาหอยเอียงสรีส้นเส้นไอ้แนวไอ้แนวเอาหอย โอ้ดอลนี้ខ្ញុំនិយាយសូមនិយាយបន្តិចគឺថាពួកប្រពន្ធប្រពន្ធគេចេញណាចេញឆ្នាំ65យុនយ៉ាតមីកាភីយាយយឹមចេញឆ្នាំ1965ពីព្រោះ63ប្តីប្តីចេញណាខ្ញុំអ្នកនាំចេញដាក់ឡានទៅចុះព្រំប្រទល់ Hãy tạ tôn tình năng lúc khi dụp hôn đấy cứ miền ai cứ xa lệch IS mà phây cho mà phây bẩm bấy Trong y ân chi bị xa khám ái cứ sốn, 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 bẩm pi, bẩm bấy, muối, bẩm buôn, bẩm mùi Chi bị xa ông kết sốn, sốn, muối, bẩm bấy, buôn, bẩm mùi, bẩm mùi, bẩm pi ជាភាសាបារាំងគឺ0055961690គឺលោកនុនជាបានឆ្លើយទៅនឹងសំណួរដែលថាតើលោកខៀវសំផនដែលបានប្រើឈ្មោះបរិវត្តថាហែមនោះបានចូលរួមក្នុងចលនាបដិវត្តក្នុងឆ្នាំ1965ហើយឬនៅនោះលោកនុនជាបានឆ្លើយថាខៀវសំផនកាលនោះអត់ទាន់ចូលមកឈឹមទេប៉ុន្តែគាត់ចូលបាក់ហើយ ជាមួយគ្នានេះដែរគឺលោកនុនជាក៏បានឆ្លើយនៅចំពោះមុខអង្គសាសនាការដែរថាគាត់មិនមានទំនាក់ទំនងអ្វីជាមួយនឹងខៀវសំផនហើយនឹងបញ្ញាជនផ្សេងៗទៀតទេតែខ្ញុំសូមលើកឯកសារលេខ IS 20.28 1 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15 16 និងជាភាសាបារាំង 0 0 5 9 6 7 សូននឹងជាភាសាបារាំង 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 0 0 5 ឯកសារចុងក្រោយគឺឯកសារលេខIS 20.33ឬក៏E3/26គឺជាបទសម្ភាសន៍រវាងនួនជាជាមួយនឹងអ្នកសារព័ត៌មានជប៉ុន ដោយឯកសារមុនៗដែរគឺលោកនួនជាបានរៀបរាប់នៅក្នុងបទសម្ភាសន៍នេះតាក់ទងទៅនឹងតួនាទីរបស់អៀងសេរីនិងខៀវសំផន nằm môn chân nằm ở phòng môn chất sắp ra mặt đấy. Tí hoa đôi chân nông ai kia xa ai ai xa phê cho xa sắp bay ní trọng ý ơn chì phí xa khám mai. Cứ miên lệ xôn 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 phạm bay phạm bôn phạm phí chì phí xa khám mai. Hay nâng chì phí xa ổng lê. Cứ xôn xôn bay phí phạm bôn phạm xôn phạm bay. Hay chì phí xa bà răng. Son, son, bay, from moy, bay, from bay, from moy, from bone. Though they got one first and pitch in moy, came one long snam of pond, from moroy, castle, and by dike, you look non cheap, band rib, rob, and pay tata, look in the reap, band chore room, young doing like the nung, the knong, and that come out, take a pack crumb from pain, you moy, pole pot, the base, the pack lang, way, no, no, chunk snam of pond, would have some day. In the trunk, miền ai cả xa môi tiệt đái cứ ai cả xa lệ tiệt đái lắm cứ miền yêu ăn chìm xa khăm ai cứ lệ sốn 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 làm buồn rối nâng chìm xa ông lệ sốn sốn bay pi làm buồn pram môi môi chìm xa bờ rắn cứ sốn sốn làm môi bay làm pi pi I got to lie the nuns of Nora Bonnet Sample, the men you pond that tongue, the nun tan look his pond for men of night, like Cron Tai Chip of Mokron. Penunun Chip and Slide that God come in of night die. God man, man, tak me in of day, come in soft day. But Lopatin, I guess, and Niku, a room, Jimoin, I guess, Chichran did die, young band, Turkas, soothing doll. Chỉ mỗi nôn chia cà phê còn lo mà còn không sao mà cà vậy đấy cứ bàn đặt số định đào này hái hay là về đấy nhắm số mình chọc cà bằng hai bọc nhắm tầm đấy hay xả cà rây bọc nhắm nâng bình to bật than thế bằng số một con
mình tới khang dạ bên nhà anh rồng anh trai chết thời ca pe bì liệp hai bao man tiết nông ca đã bằng hai cái thá trong cày
thank you good afternoon Mr. President I do not have very much to present partly because we've had a lot of time to present documents directly to Noon Chea and I also had Thursday afternoon but I have probably about 10 possibly to 15 minutes no more than that
mình chỉ lơ hơ pi 10 tới 15 នាទី ទេ
បាទ អរគុណ ប៉ុន្តែ ឥឡូវ នេះ ដល់ ពេល សម លមម នឹង សម្រាប់ ហើយ យើង ឲ្យ ជម្រះ ប្រកាស សម្រាប់ 20 នាទី ចាប់ ពី ពេល នេះ ទៅ រហូត ដល់ ម៉ោង 3 15 នាទី សូម អញ្ជើញ ចូល វិញ ដើម្បី បន្ត កិច្ច ដំណើរការ សកម្មភាព សម្រាប់ ចុះ
សូម ក្រោក ឈរ